Child of the sun, what do you dream? I will always look forward to my lover the way I do the sun.
Yeah.
My name is Debbie Martine Hardy of Martine's Dream, and I don't camouflage. I'm originally from Jamaica, West Indies. I came here as a teenager and I lived in Brooklyn right away. I came here and stayed with an aunt, so I was tossed right into Brooklyn. I didn't love it at first and I was missing home. Went to school, I was a teenager at the time, and then went to college and worked while I was going to college. And then I moved to Queens and moved around a little bit and I came back. A friend of mine was living in Fort Greene and I came to visit him. And I was just like, I want to live here. Brooklyn started to come to life for me. I wasn't very good at following rules. I knew that a long time ago when I was a kid. I was kind of quiet. If everyone else was wearing brown shoes when I was in Catholic high school, mine would be maroon. Prints and patterns just always spoke to me. It was shaping in me from when I was a little girl. And a lot of the stuff I would wear, I would kind of mix up the patterns and sometimes I mix up the colors. I love stuff with circles. It became clear to me like some years ago when I was looking at a lot of the art that I collected when I travel, a lot of the textile that I collected, and I realized that a lot of it had a circular movement in it. I'm also drawn to anything that has a tribal feel. It speaks to my heart, like literally. Certain things were shaping in me from when I was a child in Jamaica, and that's also to the travels, because I couldn't at the time, but I would always dream about it. Your imagination can take flight. Mine kind of took flight, really. I said, one day if I'm able to travel, I want to take a trip to India because of pictures of that I saw. Same thing with the Maasai. I wanted to go visit the Maasai in East Africa because of a photograph I saw when I was a child. I didn't take to modeling very well. But what was good for me with that, from being in front of the camera, I learned that I really wanted to be behind the camera, and that's how I started building my portfolio as a stylist. Later, I started working with an artist and started to travel, but I knew I wanted to do something for myself. Martine's Dreaming is a feeling. I love everyday people. Just moving around with people here in Brooklyn, and it can just be anyone. It's just how you connect. In travels, it's the same thing. Sometimes you're on a train or on a bus and you end up meeting someone and they're like, I'm from this particular village. You want to go to the village and not necessarily to go connect with them in that village, but just to get a sense of where they live because you see certain things about them. It could be the smile about them, the joy about them, something. When I travel, I go into villages because I think real life and everyday life happen in villages. That same kind of sensibility is here. Where there's a village here in Brooklyn. Among all the changes and all the stuff that is happening, there's still that village thing for me. The people that I first connected with when I moved to Brooklyn, some of those people are here. I know their children. Sometimes people come in, they drop their children off. I keep them for a few hours. I'm a part of that village. So I'm a part of that village here. I'm connected to that village or villages as I travel. Having a shop, it's like being in a village and the village rallies behind you. You know, where you set this thing up and it's your dream, but people help you to realize that dream. The love and the support, and they come together and do these little things. Like someone could be going by and they're like, you want a juice? And I was like, yeah, what kind of juice? They go up the street, they get you, you know, get you a green juice. Just people caring about you and connecting with you. It's okay to have their input, and it's embraced by me, and they kind of help to shape little things at different times, and I think it's wonderful. There's so much love, Aiko, in this space, like so much love.